Hi, my name is Jose Medina, aka Tony, and this is my first, official YouTube video. Not really. Maybe. I don't know. So I actually want to talk about 12 life lessons I've learned in my life, and I'm going to be 30 years old, and I felt like I fucked up most of my life, but I've lived and I've learned, and whether you're in your 20s or you're in your 30s or you're a teenager, I want to see if these life lessons are some things that you guys can relate to as well. So number one is having a life purpose and running towards the things that make you alive or running towards things that make you scared. I've lived 20 years in denial of what I truly wanted to be in my life, whether it was being an actor, whether it's being a teacher, and running towards things and giving it all you have or making the most out of any situation is so important in your development. And I guess that's what we all try to do, is to have a sense of purpose in our lives. My second life lesson that I've learned in my life is try your best not to self-sabotage yourself. And what I mean is, whether you're losing 10, 15 pounds, or whether you're finally in a relationship with somebody you care about, or trying to beat your records, somehow the mind sabotages itself. And if you're aware of it, you can actually make a lot of changes in order to actually continue in the path that you truly desire. On a side note, I'm in a cafe right now, so it's a bit loud, but it's all right. Pretty okay. And going back to my main point, we are sometimes our worst enemy, where we will simply do whatever it takes to not make ourselves happy. It's like our minds purposely want us to be in a state of grief, and making sure that we don't sabotage ourselves, and the moment we realize we are doing that, we can make some course corrections. And this leads to my third point, where it's consistency is key. Consistency in managing your mind, consistency in managing your budget, consistency in managing every aspect of your life is so important. And, well, it's something that I struggle with, it's something that my friends struggle with, and just recently I kind of learned how to work with that, and it's simply just using your phone, I have an iPhone, and putting reminders of the habits you want to keep, the habits that you need to keep, the structure, the routine, and following that as much as you can. And maybe one or two days you don't follow it, but as long as you go back and come back to the main objective and back to those habits, you still have consistency. Some people say it's every day. I say maybe occasionally, because sometimes life gets in the way and you have to make the most of what you're given with. And it's important to really train your mind to do the things you need to do and be the person you need to be. And my fourth life lesson that I've learned just recently, it's like the mind believes what you tell it. And it's true, you gotta tell it good things. You can't be in denial, you can't rationalize things, but you could say, yeah, you know what, I have a spending problem. I need to work on this issue. I need to make sure that I know how much I spend per day, or I need to do this, I need to do that, or maybe I am shallow, maybe I am a little picky, maybe I am a little thing. But telling your mind what you need to know, what you want it to do, hey, you're on top of it, you're discerning, you're wise, you're patient, you're frugal, telling the things that you want it to do, rather than tell it the things that you don't want it to do. And I don't know whether it's not, but it's always a battle with your own mind, so you gotta see what you can do with it. And this leads to my fifth life lesson. If you tell your mind what it needs to know, maybe tell it to be discerning. And what I mean is, you can't trust everyone. I've trusted the wrong people in my life, and I've made a lot of stupid decisions. A lot of decisions. Trusting the wrong roommate. Trusting the wrong person. Saying the wrong thing. losing a job because somebody didn't have bad, good intentions for me. I wonder if that's something that every person has experienced, which I'm pretty sure they have. But or making a friend who you find out that's fake towards you. I guess maybe how I learned how to work with that is to just give little small tests on people, making sure that I'm able to see if the person has any yellow flags or red flags or green flags. Green flags meaning they're a real friend. Yellow flags meaning there's some negative qualities I need to look at. Red flags mean like definite givens I need to like pay attention to. And one person can throw away your whole entire, can ruin you even financially, spiritually and everything. And I think another tool, another life lesson, this leads to my sixth point, is in order to prepare for life circumstances, always have a budget that's realistic to you. I suck at this one. I really do suck at budgeting. But knowing how much I should spend on a lift, or knowing how much I should spend for groceries, knowing how much money I come into, it's a hassle, but I don't know. Other people are phenomenal at budgeting. I'm just mediocre at best. So that leads to my seventh point, which is unrelated to budgeting, but be there for those people who have your back. People who actually look out for you. I learned in life that a real friend isn't somebody that you just have fun with, because you can have fun with a lot of your party friends, but I don't know where you figured out that they just love to party, or they're the ones who are talking the most shit about you. And just because you have wonderful chemistry with the person doesn't mean that they're really your friend or people that can stay with you. And so be there for the people that do have your back. Listen to them, be there for them. It's really hard, but you never know. Life is really short, so to get even with people that hate you, and rather you should be getting even with the people that have uplifted you and help them out in whatever way you can. This is a different topic. This is my eighth life lesson that I've learned, which is have some hobbies. And I mean, having a hobby, whether it's painting, drawing, singing, even if you're I'm a bad singer, I'm awful at singing. Dancing, maybe watching YouTube videos, some kind of hobby that makes you manage your stress levels in your life. I mean, the world consumes you. You always work, have to pay bills, you have to do all these things and deal with toxic people. And having some kind of hobbies, whether it may be silly to other people, but wonderful for you, it's your own life. Do the things that make you really happy on the inside. It's so important. And this leads to my ninth point, and I'll explain how it leads to it. It's like, don't put someone on a pedestal or try to uplift someone so much that it takes away from you. Because every time when you adore someone, you somehow kind of lose yourself. Whether you're in a new relationship, you lose part of yourself, part of your identity becomes mingled with somebody else, and it distracts you from your goals, it distracts you from who you really want to be. So I would say, make sure that you're not putting someone on a pedestal, because they have their flaws, they fuck up. And if they're super self-absorbed, they're the only ones who's going to benefit from your admiration and your energy and your attention. So try your best to just be self, wouldn't say self-reliant, but aware of the fact that we tend to put a lot of energy onto other people who don't care enough about us. Maybe my life lesson, I don't know. The 10th one that I've learned is just to have faith. Have faith that everything will eventually work out and be wonderful in the end, or as crazy or crappy it might be, have faith you can endure something, because I think, well, I don't think, I know everybody goes through some bullshit, and, well, we all go through it. So have faith. And then my 11th life lesson, sorry, this is a bit rushed, is never really be ashamed of who you are or where you come from. I have friends like myself who are from South LA that when they went to college that they feel incredibly ashamed of their heritage, and they try to be something that they're not, and it only kind of adds to a falseness of their own identity and probably leads to existential crises on a regular basis. So having the ability to cling on to your culture and cling on to who you really are as a person is important. So never be ashamed of who you are. And my last point, my last life lesson that I've learned is to have a good healthy amount of self-confidence, because what I think distinguishes a boy from a man is just the ability to be confident in oneself. Generally self-confident, because I don't think you can really truly exist in this world and feel healthy about yourself if you're not confident in what you have or who you are or what you say or what you do. Confidence doesn't mean arrogance. It just means knowing you'll get the job done, knowing that you exist, knowing that you're able to do things. So, as I'm kissing away my 20s, I fucked up a lot. But saying, you know what, if any of these life lessons resonate with you, then let me know. Write down in the comments. Thank you.